under the lights. It was electric. In this edition of Inside Blue Host Football, we're going to talk with the coach about that home opener and all the fireworks that happened on the field before the real fireworks took off at the end of the game. We'll dissect that game, look ahead to the Furman Paladins, and a lot more on this edition of Inside Blue Host Football. Glad to have you with us on this edition of Inside Blue Host Football. I'm your host, Eric Thacker, along with the coach himself, Harold Nichols. Coach, congratulations on a fantastic win for your Blue Hose, opening up the season at home in the home opener under the lights. A complete victory in all aspects of the game for PC.
You know, I was really proud of our kids, Eric. You know, coming back home after a tough loss up there in Illinois, against a good Husky squad. We come back and had a lot of energy in the stadium. Really proud of all of our fans coming back. You know, first night game since 1990, and you could feel the energy in the stadium. And I think our kids fed off of that a little bit. A lot of respect for Coach Walker and his program, what he's trying to build there. It wasn't so much about who we were playing as much as us improving from week one to week two. And I think we were able to do that. Executed on offense, took care of business, did what we had to do, able to run the football. You know, had three or four backs that, you know, scored touchdowns in the game, and played a lot of people. Got a lot of people, a lot of reps on both sides of the ball. We were sound in the kicking game, made some plays in the kicking game, and I tell our players all the time, you know, it's hard enough sometimes when we're doing stuff on air, much less when there's 11 guys on the other side. And but just really proud of the way that our kids came out. They were ready to play. Our coaching staff did a good job getting them ready. So it was just a great night all in all. And you mentioned the fireworks at the end of the game. And, you know, like I said, you could feel the energy in the stadium. And for us to be able to come back home in our home opener, it couldn't have gone any better.
Well, we talked about the skill position players, running backs, receivers, quarterbacks, that this has probably been the best group of skill position players that PC has ever enjoyed in their football history. Jeremiah Mackey was dressed, wasn't going to play, and there was a little concern, at least you know, from us, from the reporting end of it, that we could have had a drop-off there. Boy, were we ever wrong about that.
Well, you know, Jeremiah had dinged his ankle against Northern Illinois. He probably could have played push come to shove. I was trying to hold him out if we absolutely could. You know, I was really proud of the way that Devron Glenn and DJ Wilson, Marquell Hines, the young guy that I've got in there in the slot.
Number 81.
And, and so I think that those guys coming on and playing on that stage did a really nice job. And not only at receiver, but also in the return game, too. So I thought the backs, I thought the quarterbacks played well, and the receivers, we did some really nice things in there to keep us going.
And we've got all kinds of highlights to share with you. Usually we spend about 4 minutes talking things before we go to highlights, but I think we have so many that we need to jump to the highlights right now. The Rams of Bluefield against our Blue Hose.
Game Highlights is brought to you by Cooper Motor Company. If you can't trade with Cooper, you just can't trade.
Here we are in the first quarter on defense. There's Bluefield throwing a little, trying to throw a little three-step right there, and the corner jumps it. We get a big sack. I think this is a third down sack by Mitch Anderson, who played really good. Did a nice job using his hands. Nice job on the sack right there for tackle for loss. So real excited early on by our defense. Here, this is late in the first quarter. Back on defense again. Run a little option, which they do out of the gun, and I think that was Donnell. Donnell played that really well, number 32 right there. Really good to see old 32 back in there going. Does a nice job reading it, scraping, and it makes a nice tackle for loss right there for us. So really good to see him going again. Here are about 5 minutes to go in the second quarter. Bluefield motioning back in. It's kind of a three-back set and trying to run a little play-action pass, and Kevin does a nice job breaking on the slant right there on number 81, who had some catches against us on the night and was a really, really good player. And but Kevin does a nice job defending the slant here off of play-action and breaking it up. And so, you know, Kevin's going to have to play with a lot of confidence here moving forward. Late in the game right here, throw a little bubble pass, and there's Xavier Raley. Jumps the pop pass. I think he got a penalty here for grabbing the guy's face mask inadvertently here, but really happy to see X getting some playing time here in the second half, and really nice break, nice job. He just got to kind of keep his hands off of his face mask there, but he made a nice play. He really did. Go to some offensive highlights here. We had a few of them. Like I say, he was able to run the ball pretty effectively all night. There's Laquay Mays back there in the backfield at tailback. Hayes in there at quarterback, and run a little motion right there, hand it off to Laquay. Big hole in the middle right there, and he hits it. That's one thing that I've noticed about Laquay here.
In between the tackles?
Yeah, he's done a nice job, you know. And it started back in spring practice. He started having a little really good vision and you know, seeing a hole and hitting it and, you know, not dancing a whole lot, just trying to get be a north and south runner. And a really nice job by him there. I think that's Darryl Bridges back there at tailback now. Hayes underneath the center, run a little motion, hand it off to Darryl, breaks the tackle right there, makes a nice cut. Good job by Blake Roberts in there at the fullback position. So, you know, had a nice play right there. Sorts out the linebacker and creates a little crease right there for a good 8-10-yard gain. Nice job by Darryl. Going the other way here, I think this is the second quarter. This might be the touchdown pass here. I'm not sure, but run a little seam route up the numbers for DJ, and Hayes puts just enough on it. DJ runs up underneath it. Big touchdown catch by DJ right there. And thought Hayes played pretty proficient all night. You know, I think he was 7-8 throwing the ball, and here he is getting up on top of his toes, putting nice air underneath the ball, puts it where it needs to be, and DJ made a nice play right there for the catch.
Two touchdowns for him.
Here we are back on offense. We're in a trip set here, and Hayes in there at quarterback. Devron Glenn really makes a nice play here, adjusting back to the ball. Hayes kind of put it back in there behind him a little bit, running stride side with the corner, puts it in a good spot, and that's, you know, shows a maturing quarterback right there, being able to make throws like that. Here we are back in a kind of a two-back set. We had a lot of these sets the other night. Run a little outside zone, get some good blocking right there, and Darryl really hits it. He's starting to get healthy again. You can kind of see a little spring in his step. He's a hard back to tackle. Offensive line did a nice job right there picking up a little stunt that they had, and Darryl breaks the tackle and gets another 10 or 12 yards. Nice job by Darryl Bridges. Here we are. I think this is back to that first drive. This may have been the first touchdown. Laquay does a nice job kind of winding it back on the zone. Good vision at the second level. Guys did a nice job right there just running through the heels of the lineman. Hayes McMath actually with a little block right there to get him in the end zone. But nice job by Laquay on the touchdown. Here we are on a kickoff. I think this might have been the one that we scored on. Get a decent kick right there, and we come down, and Steve does a nice job putting his hat on the ball. And this is just one where we stuck it back there. We had good coverage all night. You can see Corey and Ed Britt and Kevin Crawford knifing, but that's a big play. You know, you put him down there at the 8-yard line. Really nice job by them.
Game Highlights is brought to you by Cooper Motor Company. If you can't trade with Cooper, you just can't trade.
Always nice to have a lot of highlights. One that we didn't get to see was Laquay May's 92-yard TD run, which was a record setter for the Big South Conference, the longest run for a TD in conference history. Well, now let's go ahead and take a look at our Nichols Automotive Collision of the Week.
This is the one that I think Ed Britt was able to scoop and score on, you know. And again, you know, the coverage units are big, you know, to be able to kick the ball down there and have some speed and cover. You know, I think we're so much better there, but you can see Steve knifing in, actually gets hit in the back, and then Ed Britt picks it up and goes in and scores for the Blue Hose right there. So a nice job by Steve and Ed and all of our coverage unit, really, for most of the night. We kicked off a good bit the other night and really got a lot of work on our kickoff coverage team. Nice job, score for the Blue Hose.
Coach, not only a collision of the week, but a nice scoop and score as well. Let's go ahead and take a timeout. When we come back, we're going to take a look at our Palmetto Bone and Joint Injury Report and also have a visit with Coach's Corner.
Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you by Founders Federal Credit Union. Relax, you're with Founders. By Self Regional Healthcare, we bring advanced care closer. And by Fats Cafe of Clinton.
Special about Fats to me is the fact that we have so much passion. We just take a lot of pride in what we do and deliver to our guests every single day. When it comes to our buildings, when it comes to our food, our ingredients, we have competitive pricing. We offer value. We bring it every day. Why would I go to the competition and play in the minor leagues when I can play in the big leagues at Fats?
We're fighting cancer with caring, with technology, with knowledge, and now with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self-Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
Yeah, you know, when I'm on the road, I love it. I love getting out there and playing for the fans, but, you know, I do miss my family. I miss my friends and miss the food and Bojangles and perfectly seasoned chicken, the made-from-scratch biscuits and legendary sweet tea. It's tough being away from that.
Scotty, isn't that your family?
Scotty! I don't think he's stopping.
They ought to know my routine by now. We're going to Bojangles. Bring him back some chicken. He'll be all right.
Oh, you won't believe what just happened.
Don't tell me you got the last Diet Dew.
Yeah.
I love the taste of Diet Dew. What do you want for it? Deal.
Diet Mountain Dew. Yeah, it tastes that good.
Hey, Hotshot. Meter's running.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you by Bojangles. It's bow time. And by Pepsi. Refresh everything.
We welcome you back to Inside Blue Hose Football. And I know that Cedric Byrd had a little bit of an issue in the early part of the first quarter. We talked about Jeremiah Mackey being out a little bit. But after week two, it seems like we're still pretty much healthy.
Yeah, not anywhere close to where we were last year. You know, remember, we were after the first couple of weeks, we were ravaged injury-wise. But, you know, Sed's got a lower leg deal, trying to work through that right here. Hopefully he'll be able to get back and get going again. But, like I say, knock on wood, you know, hopefully we've gotten to a point now where we've gotten some depth and playing a lot of guys, too, which I think will, you know, play a big part in it down the stretch here. But big shout-out to our orthopedics there at Palmetto Bone and Joint, because they do a great job keeping our kids healthy, getting them back out on the field. And so we've been pretty lucky so far. Hopefully that will continue here as we get going here.
Last week we talked about the long snap and how important that is in special teams in the game of football. Mm-hmm. In this edition of Coach's Corner, the one guy that receives that long snap is our own Stephen Doerr, who's emerging as one of the best punters in the conference. Mm-hmm. So, Stephen Doerr as part of this week's Coach's Corner.
Coach's Corner is brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm. Like a good neighbor, State Farm and Matt Davis is there.
Welcome to this week's edition of Coach's Corner. I'm Harold Nichols, head coach here at PC, and this is Stephen Doerr, redshirt junior punter from Landrum High School. And we're going to talk about the fundamentals of punting a football. The biggest thing is probably three ingredients. One, your drop. Two, your body position. And three, your follow through. All right, so Stephen's going to put on his helmet. We're going to talk about those three things right here. Stephen, come over here with me. We can get a good shot of you right here. Couple things. One, all right, your drop is probably the most important in your body position, okay? You want to have a good balanced position. You want to try to lead and be a two-step punter. Lead with your right foot, all right? Be a two-step punter, all right? The drop is really, really critical on this. You want to make sure as you drop the football, you have an extended out waist level, all right? You don't want to drop the ball too high. You don't want to drop the ball too low. So you got minimal play in the drop as foot meets leather there, all right? Now, we're going to kind of walk through the two-step process being a punter. You want to have your hips in a line with the area that you want to punt the ball to. All right, head position, shoulders over your toes. So as Stevens takes that first step, we're going to kind of walk through it right here. He takes that first step, and that plant steps that left foot on the two-step operation right there. And then your drop comes, your shoulders are over your toes, and then foot will meet leather right there. Okay, so we're going to try to do it full speed here one time with you. Okay, as he comes through, I'll give him a command on the catch, and probably the most important thing about being a punter is catching the ball. You got to catch the snap first, all right, before you do anything else. So that's a really important part to this whole process. You got to be hands and eyes together, catch the football, and make sure you have a good drop, a good two-step process, and then a follow-through as your leg comes through the ball. All right, so I'm going to give Stephen a command. He's going to kind of show you the two-step process, the drop, body position, and the follow-through. Set. Right there, that's good. All right, we'll go one more time. If you notice, the biggest thing is the crowd will tell you where the ball goes. So keep your head down, make sure you get a good drop, and make sure your good flat foot meets leather. I want to do one more time. A good two-step process, lead with your right foot, two steps, shoulders over your toes, good drop, toe meets leather, and here we go. All right, Stephen. Set. Three steps in the process, body position, drop, follow through. Got to catch the ball first. This is Stephen Doerr, punter here at PC. I'm Harold Nichols, and this has been this week's edition of Coach's Corner.
Coach's Corner is brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm. Like a good neighbor, State Farm and Matt Davis is there.
Always great to visit with Stephen Doerr, but Coach, you love football, and you love to applaud anybody that does well on the gridiron, even if it's the opposition. Mm-hmm. Their punter for the Bluefield Rams wasn't too shabby either. He really did make Toby Antigua catch it over his shoulder.
Yeah, he did. You know, he did not play in that first week. This was his first week playing, so really didn't know what to expect from him. But he did a little rugby kick there and really got a hold of a couple. And so he'll be a good weapon for them as they go down the stretch for their year.
Mm-hmm. Ray Guy gets put into the Hall of Fame finally as a punter. And inside Blue Hose football, you punters get some love as well. Let's go ahead and take a timeout. When we come back, the Furman Paladins. We know what happened last year. We're going to talk to Coach about what under the lights here at Bailey Memorial Stadium may mean for PC when we return to Inside Blue Hose Football.
We're fighting cancer with caring, with technology, with knowledge, and now with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self-Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
That's a wrap, Scotty. Let's break for lunch, guys.
All right, it's boat time.
Two-piece dinner.
Right here.
Hey, I had a two-piece dinner.
Relax, man. We got more. Cajun filet biscuit.
That's me.
You got a Cajun filet biscuit and a two-piece dinner?
So what's your point?
Man, you can't have breakfast and lunch together. That doesn't work.
Works for me. I call it brunch.
Get our famous chicken, made from scratch buttermilk biscuits, and legendary iced tea anytime you crave it. Bojangles, it's bow time.
Let's go! Oh yeah! Reach for the sky! We go! Yeah! Yeah!
As you set your financial game plan, we'll be with you every play. Relax, you're with Founder.
Oh, you won't believe what just happened.
Don't tell me you got the last Diet Dew.
Yeah.
I love the taste of Diet Dew. What do you want for it? Deal.
Diet Mountain Dew. Yeah, it tastes that good.
Hey, Hotshot. Meter's running.
What's special about Fats to me is the fact that we have so much passion. We just take a lot of pride in what we do and deliver to our guests every single day. When it comes to our buildings, when it comes to our food, our ingredients, we have competitive pricing. We offer value. We bring it every day. Why would I go to the competition and play in the minor leagues when I can play in the big leagues at Fats?
In the NCAA Division I Football Championship Subdivision, the game is played with perseverance, integrity, passion, character, and sportsmanship as he works to honor the game and respect his teammates, opponents, officials, and fans. Every FCS player grows in his responsibilities as a student athlete and as a member of his campus and community. The NCAA Division I Football Championship Subdivision. Every down, every day. This portion of Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you by McDonald's of Lawrence and Clinton. I'm loving it. And by Carolina Fresh Farms, the official turf grass of Presbyterian College.
The Furman Paladins, the name in itself means a lot here, especially what happened last year. Coach, I know that you play and replay that thing through your head, the last Presbyterian College drive, and everybody else that wants to take a look at it, PC did the right thing. You scripted it perfectly. It just didn't turn out the way we wanted. But now is the time to answer that. You get the Paladins at home, just a few hours away from kickoff, under the lights again. Tell us a bit about the Furman Paladins, who don't have their starting quarterback, and break down the game, what PC needs to do to get the win.
Well, you know, Furman is still a really good team.
Despite, right?
Well, you know, despite losing their quarterback, they're a top 20 football team, and deservingly so. They're 2-0. The young man that they came in and played after their quarterback got hurt against Mercer played really well. He's a dynamic young player. He can make plays with his legs. He can make all the throws. You can see that on film. They still got that tailback, Hank McLeod, who's one of the better backs in the country. Big challenge for us defensively, no doubt. And then, you know, a typical Furman team, coached by Coach Fowler there, they're solid defensively. They do a good job of tackling. They're where they're supposed to be. So, you know, we're going to have to be able to string some first downs together. And, So like I said, it'll be challenging that way too. So, and then they're always sound in the kicking game. You know, you can never really compare year to year. That's a tough
thing
to do.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, you do a lot of self-analyzation, you know, in the off season about, you know, woulda, shoulda, coulda, shoulda done this, shoulda did that. And, you know, really, you know, we've kind of shelved all that, you know, learned the lesson, forget the details and move on. This game, I'm sure, will take on its own personality. Every year does. Every game does. You got to take them week by week. And it's an old coaching thing that you hear coaches say all the time about, well, it's one week at a time, one opponent at a time. And realistically, that's the only way that you can approach this game. Will playing at home help us? I certainly would hope so. We would have some type of home field advantage. Playing at night, more energy in the stadium. I think all those things are good. But again, you know, Furman is an established FCS program that for a long time, you know, we're trying to build this program and set a foundation so we can be competitive with schools like Furman. And a healthy respect for them and what they've been able to accomplish in their program's history. But, you know, we've got to be competitive in games like this. And hopefully we can find a way to get a couple first downs together and go try to find a way to win. And, you know, our kids are excited about that.
One player that didn't get to play in that contest mm-hmm. last year was your quarterback, Hayes McMath. Mm-hmm. So I'm sure he's anxious to show what he can do leading the PC offense against the Paladin defense.
Yeah, right? I think, you know, Hayes, when we kind of inserted him into the offense, you know, their middle of the year last year, I think he does add a little couple different dynamics to it. And, you know, he'll be anxious to play in this game, I'm sure. And so hopefully he'll be able to do some things to help us move the football. And you know, I thought Caleb played really well against him last year and did some really nice things. So, you know, we're going to have a good plan. And because, like I say, Furman will be definitely a tough opponent.
Special teams, special teams, mm-hmm. special teams. Kickoff coverage, punt coverage. Kickoff return, punt return. And let's not forget our place kicking and, of course, Stephen Doerr. Mm-hmm. Electric atmosphere tonight under the lights again. This is a rivalry that is beginning to come back up to the top. And we're going to need everybody there at Bailey Memorial Stadium in a few hours. Make the trip. For the coach, Harold Nichols, I'm Eric Thacker, saying we'll see you tonight. The Blue Hose in Furman. Go PC.
Inside Blue Hose Football was brought to you by Founders Federal Credit Union. Relax, you're with Founders. By Self Regional Healthcare, we bring advanced care closer. And by Fats Cafe of Clinton.